everyone. Welcome to JEE Max, JEE Mains Advanced Extreme Series. Welcome to Season 2 of JEE Max. So far, we have successfully completed Season 1. Through that Season 1, we have completed most important topics of JEE Mains and Advanced. Now, through this Season 2, we are completely concentrating on complex numbers, the most weightage topic of the JEE Mains and Advanced Examination. And successfully we have completed lesson number one of the complex number. This is about lesson number two. Through that Venn diagram itself, you will get an idea about the relations between a set of natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers and irrational numbers, and a set of real numbers as well as set of imaginary numbers, and what is about complex numbers. Okay. Now this is about lesson two of complex numbers. My friends, please don't forget to check the description there. I am providing very good information for you. I am providing the question papers and somewhat assignments and some tests also for you. Okay. Now this is lesson number two of complex numbers. Through this lesson, I am concentrating on real and imaginary parts of the complex numbers and the conjugate of the complex number and inverse of the complex number, division of the complex numbers. In lesson one, we have practiced how to add complex numbers, how can we multiply the complex numbers, and how two complex numbers are said to be equal. All that we have discussed in lesson number one. Now, in this one, we are concentrating the remaining operations of the complex numbers. Now, coming to real and imaginary part of the complex numbers. See, if Z is equal, in general, complex number, set of complex numbers is denoted with the C. So, set C is equal to set of all complex numbers of the form Z, which is equal to A plus IB, where A comma B are real numbers and I is a symbol represented with minus 1, is also called iota. In general, the complex numbers are represented with Z, small Z. If Z is equal to A plus IB, then here, this number A, this is called real part of the complex number, usually denoted with the real Z. And this B represented that as imaginary part of the complex number, that in general represented with IMZ, that is B, not IB. That B indicates what? Imaginary part of the complex number. So, if Z is equal to A plus IB, I can write this as what? Real Z plus I imaginary Z. So, IMZ means imaginary part of the Z, and A means real part of Z. If A equal to 0, then Z is nothing but what? IB only. In this case, this complex number is called purely imaginary. It is called what? Purely imaginary. So, when can I say a complex number Z is purely imaginary? Imaginary of Z is 0. Whenever B equal to 0, then Z becomes what? A only. In this case, it is called purely real. It is called what? Purely real. So, when can I say a complex number is purely real if its real part, imaginary Z is equal to 0? So, whenever imaginary Z is 0, then that is purely real. Whenever real Z is 0, then that is purely imaginary. And if a complex number is said to be non-zero, if at least one of A comma B not equal to 0, that is very, very important. Okay. Now, the same things that I have explained here, types of complex numbers. A complex number Z is equal to X plus IY, where X comma Y belongs to capital R, is real if Y equal to 0, that is imaginary part is 0. Imaginary if Y not equal to 0, that is imaginary of Z not equal to 0. Clear? So, it is real if Y equal to 0. Imaginary if Y not equal to 0, that is imaginary part not equal to 0. All right. Similarly, purely imaginary if X is equal to 0, that is real part of Z is equal to 0. So, these are the simple clear-cut differences between existing of a complex number in different forms. Now, coming to the important note. as I mentioned in the last video also, this 0 plus I0 is the only complex number. It is both real and imaginary. So, as a bit also, it is very, very important statement. Any complex number which is both real and imaginary, or purely real and imaginary, is nothing but what? 0. So, this is the only number which is both real and imaginary. Because every real number is a complex number. In that aspect also, we can say. Now, another important definition is conjugate of the complex number. If z is equal to x plus iy is any complex number, then conjugate of z is denoted with z bar and is defined as x minus iy. So, if z is equal to x plus iy is a complex number, then z bar is represented with the conjugate of the complex number and is defined as x minus iy. That means we are just replacing plus iy with minus iy here. That is notation denoted with z bar. How to read it as z bar. Now, the properties of conjugate. Z bar whole bar is equal to z. How? If z is equal to x plus iy, then what is z bar? X minus iy. What is z bar whole bar? That is x minus iy whole bar. That is nothing but x plus iy. As per definition of it. That's why z bar whole bar is equal to z. Similarly, z1 plus z2 whole bar is equal to, suppose, say this is x1, z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1, z2 equal to x2 plus iy2. What is z1 bar? That is x1 minus iy1. And what is z2 bar? That is x2 minus iy2. What is z1 plus z2? That as per the definition of addition of complex numbers, I am adding the real part aside and imaginary part immediately after I. What is z1 plus z2 whole bar? Z1 plus z2 whole bar is by definition x1 plus x2 minus I into y1 plus y2. This also I can write it as x1 plus I y1 minus I into x2 plus I y2. This is nothing but z1 bar z1 bar plus z2, sorry, plus here. Here also it is this plus x1 z1 plus z2 whole bar. This is minus. Once again, z1 plus z2 whole bar is equal to z1 plus z2 whole bar is equal to x1 plus x2 minus I into y1 plus y2. This I can write it as x1 minus I y1 plus x2 minus I y2. This already, this represented with z1 bar and this represented with z2 bar. Like that, the remaining properties we can find it very easily. Similarly, z1 z2 whole bar is equal, that means product of conjugate of product of two complex numbers is equal to product of the conjugates individually. Similarly, conjugate of the quotient of two complex numbers is equal to quotient of their conjugates. And fourth property, z plus z bar. Suppose if z is equal to x plus iy. Suppose if z is equal to x plus iy. Say for example, if z is equal to x plus iy, then z bar is equal to x minus iy. What is z plus z bar? That is 2x only, if I am adding. What is 2x? That is 2 real z. Similarly, what is z minus z bar? That is 2iy. What is that? I into 2i into 2i imaginary z. That I can write. So, z plus z bar is equal to 2 real z. Z minus z bar is equal to 2i imaginary z. You need to focus and you need to practice all these formulae. They are not formulae. Actually, one should understand the basic operation. How can we apply the basic addition and subtraction between the complex numbers? Thereby, you will easily get this idea and you will easily understood the formulae. Okay. And these are the basic information, because in coming problems, we will get these terms in our questions instead of there, instead of writing everything on paper, if you are utilizing this as formulae, you will save the time also. That's why you need to focus, and every property is a bit also for you. Now coming to inverse of the complex number. If z is equal to x plus I y is any non-zero complex number. Is any non-zero complex numbers means not both x and y are zero. Both not x, both x and y not equal to zero simultaneously. Then the inverse of z is denoted with z power minus 1, which is defined as 1 by z. That is 1 by x plus I y. This I can write it as, now I am multiplying with the conjugate for both numerator and denominator. So it is like this only. Because whenever a complex number is given for you, then we need to write or we need to express that in the form of x plus I y form only, or a plus I b form only. That's why conveniently I am just multiplying both numerator and denominator with its conjugate. So numerator is x minus I y, denominator is x plus I y into x minus I y, z bar is equal to, this is x square minus minus x I y, I x y plus I x y, I square minus I square y square. So this is nothing but x minus I y by this minus I x y plus I x y gets cancelled. I square is minus 1. So you can get that as x square plus y square. If I have separated that, that becomes x by x square plus y square plus I into minus y by x square plus y square. So finally what I am doing is, whenever any unknown structure of the complex number is given for you, unknown structure is not in the form of a plus ib is given for you, then by doing some manipulations, we are just converting them into the known form, that is a plus ib form. Here, to get how can I represent 1 by x plus iy into x plus iy form, there I am multiplying both numerator and denominator with its conjugate, I will get it. This is called what? Inverse of the complex number. But the most important point is, not every complex number possesses inverse. Only non-zero complex numbers possesses inverse. And the inverse is like this only. And z inverse is equal to 1 by z. That I have given. What is x minus i y? That is nothing but z bar. And here in the form of x, in the place of x plus i y, I can write it as z bar, z. In the place of x minus i y, I can represent that with z bar. What is z bar? X square plus y square. That is mod z whole square. This is called mod z whole square. This is also the formula for z inverse. So whenever we are asking z inverse, then immediately you can write the formula as z bar by mod z whole square. This is the procedure to find the inverse of the complex numbers. And here, what is the real part? This is the real part. This is real part of inverse of the complex numbers, that is x by x square plus y square. X is nothing but what? Z plus z bar by 2. And what is x square plus y square? That is mod z whole square. All the parts that I am replacing with our previous information. And here minus y by x square plus y square is denoted with imaginary part of 1 by z. That minus y, you can write it as minus of z minus z bar by 2i. And x square plus y square, I can represent it with what? Mod z whole square. So through this information, we have learned that z bar is equal to mod z whole square. You have to practice. What is z bar? Z bar is equal to mod z whole square. That is, if z is equal to x plus I y, then z bar is nothing but x square plus y square. So from this, what is mod z? Mod z is nothing but root of x square plus y square. This is what? Modulus of the complex number. And this is real part of reciprocal or inverse of the complex number, and this imaginary part of inverse of the complex number. All these are all are individually they are bits, and we may expect questions on these particular parts. Now, coming to division of the complex numbers. Suppose z1, z2 are two complex numbers are given for you. The number which is in the denominator z2, which is a non-zero complex number, then how can we divide z1 by z2? How can we divide? Just now, as I mentioned, whenever this is given for you, we are just multiplying with the conjugate of the denominator. Then the denominator becomes z2 into z2 bar. Then numerator is z1 into z2 bar by what is z2? Z2 bar, that is mod z2 whole square. This is what division of the complex number. The same thing I can also write in the form of x plus yy and x1 plus iy2. So if z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1 and z2 is equal to x2 plus iy2, then z1 by z2 is equal to like this. So as per the formula, I am multiplying this x1 plus iy1 into z2 bar is x2 minus iy1, that is conjugate of z2, and denominator is x2 plus iy2 into x2 minus iy2, that is nothing but x2 square plus y2 square. This is the modulus of the complex number whole square, and here it is just a product of the two complex numbers numerator. There I am multiplying the real parts and x1 x2 minus minus I into I square, that is minus I square, that is plus y1 y2, and plus I into x2 y1 minus x1 y2. This is what division of the complex numbers. So here, without getting any confused, not necessary to remember the formula. Here, try to understand the procedure. How can we are dividing? How we are dividing a complex number with a non-zero complex number? This is the methodology. And from this, this is what real part of the complex number, and this is what imaginary part of the complex number. Okay, my friends. So if you like this video, please share and subscribe, and please don't press the bell icon. There you will get the complete notifications of next videos, and we will meet with the next video soon. That is lesson number 3 of complex numbers. Thank you.